Hello, welcome back. Today I'll be showing you how to make this necklace. Very beautiful. I call it Path to Royalty necklace because of its design. So many beautiful flowers. This is what I'll be showing you how to make today. And in this project, I'll be using two working thread that I have, one on my left, one on my right. You can actually do this with just a working thread, but I prefer to use two. Okay. To get this V shape, I think there are two ways in which you can arrive. You can actually start from this spot. Up to this place. Then you make a turn here. Down to this place. And up again. You turn. And you end here. Alright, the other method. And you come like this up to this spot, and you turn down to this place, and you end it here. Well, I prefer ending mine here. I don't know, depends on what you want to do. And then that's it. So for today's project, I'll be working with a size 6 crystal bead, sorry, size 8 crystal bead, size 2 sand bead, size 12 beading needle, .35 mm fishing line, my hook. Can actually use a bigger and fanciful one, and this is what I have at the moment. Crimp bead, commonly known as topper bead in Nigeria. Okay, I have my cutter, bent nose pliers, I'll start by cutting off my fishing line, cut what you can control, then go to the tiny head of my needle, simply just press a bit of the tip. Do this and insert your needle into the fishing line. And I'll start by taking off 3 sand beads. Then I cross with one. I have crossing both fishing lines with one sand bead. Put your needle together. Be careful. I have this. Pick up one on my right, 4 tan bead, still on my right. This time around, I'm going to pass my needle. Is my thread. This is my hand bead, my crystal bead. I'll go in. This is where my thread is. I'll go in from this direction. Now I stop. One crystal bead on your left. Pull down. And put this same thing here. I'm picking up 4 crystal beads. Pack the needle into the first bead after the crystal bead. Then pull. Now we have the first tan bead at the middle. One crystal bead here on my left, one on my right. I repeat the same thing again on my right. Pick up one crystal bead on my right fishing line. Pick up 4 stand beads on my right fishing line. Pull down. Pass the needle into the first bead after the crystal bead. Just like this. I repeat this again here. Pick up 4 tan beads on my left fishing line, pull down, go back into this first bead, then pull. Alright, I have this now. 1, 2, 3, 4. I will start one crystal bead here, one crystal bead here, then cross. Cross with one tan bead. Pick up one. down bead on my right fishing line, one on my left, pull down, cross both fishing lines with one stand bead. You have this. My fourth circle flower, or flower circle, whichever. This is what I have. So I'm going to repeat this. Repeat the same thing. Okay, what I have here is what I started with. So I'll repeat this side again. Repeat here again, and still cross back again. So I'll repeat this circle like 10. No, 8 more times. Sorry, 10 more times, because I'm going to have 11 of them. So I'll repeat this 9 more times plus this one. I have 10. Then I'll come back to show you how to turn. What I mean here, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I have 12 here. I'm going to end my here. I'll come back to show you how to turn. Alright, I'm back. This is what I have. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I'm going to turn. Turn to be able to continue. Or turn to be able to continue. Pick up one crystal bead on my right. Four sand bead. On my right fishing line. And cross with the first one after the crystal bead, just like we've been doing. That's what I have. This time around, I'm just going to end with two on my right fishing line. Keep this aside and work with this one. Make it fall to this place and cross. Pick up four sand bead, my left fishing line, cross with the first one, one crystal bead, four sand bead. Cross with one first hand bead after the crystal bead. I have two here now. I'll do two more times. First hand bead, pack the needle into this, then pull. I have 1, 2, 3. I have 1, 2, and I need 6. I will insert one crystal bead on my left. Okay. And this is what I have here. 1, 2, 3, 4 on my left. 1, 2 on my right. So I'll cross both fishing lines with one sand bead. See, pick up one sand bead on my right. One on my left. Cross both with one sand bead. I have my fishing line getting tight soon. Sorry, having some thread tying up here, too annoying. Let me figure it out right now. Yes, we got it. You can actually create your bracelet like this, but here you don't have to turn. I'm only turning because I want to get this shape. This is where I am now. I'm going to make this. And you're right, you just need one. Just one crystal bead. Then on your left, pick up 4 sand beads. Pull down. Go into the first one after the crystal bead, then pull. Up one crystal bead, okay. Now I will just pick up after the second crystal bead, one, two, pick up just one. This is what I'm gonna use to attach my hook. I'll show you how to do that. Pick up the tree, sorry, 4 sand beads, repeat the same thing again. One, two, three, four. Is the fifth one. Hit again. still working on my left fishing line. As you can see, cross both fishing lines with one sand bead. I cannot turn. One on my right, one on my left. Cross with one. Is what I have. So go down and turn again. I'll end it here. I'll pick up one crystal bead on my left, pass it into this sand bead. Pick up another crystal bead and go into this. Went into this first one. You pick up another crystal bead here and go into this. On again. And pick up the right one. Am I right? Pick up four sand beads. going to the first one after the pistol bead. One again. Pick up four twister bead. Sorry, four stand bead. Pass your needle into this one, pull down, top one crystal bead, and this is what I have, three on my right, three on my left. Pick up one tank bead across both fishing lines. Pick up one sand bead on your left and one on your right. Cross those fishing lines with one sand bead. Okay, now I have this. I repeat the circle again by picking up one crystal bead on my left, pass into this, pick up another one, pass into this. I'm going to pick up one crystal bead, pick up one again, then the last one for this left side. I'm going to work now with my right fishing line. Pick up one crystal bead. Four tan bead. Go into this bead here, the one after the crystal bead. Top one crystal bead again. Four tan bead. go into this one. Keep doing that. I have 5 now. Pick up the last crystal bead here. The one sand bead. Cross both fishing lines with it. Pick up one sand bead on your right, do the same on your left. Pick up one and cross both fishing lines on it, just like this. Okay, repeat the same thing here, repeat 7 more times, then I'll come back to show you how to turn to get this shape. Okay, now I've gotten to this level. I'm going to turn here to continue the other part of the V shape. This what I have now. This here I've gotten to. So I will continue to get this part. So I will show you how to turn, then we'll whip up to this side. And I will still show you how to complete it down to this side. Now I'll just pick up one crystal bead on my right fishing line. Just one on my right, and that's all. Pick up one on my left. Go into this bead just like I've been doing before. Pick up one, go into that bead. Pick up one, four sand bead,
pick up one crystal bead. Cross both fishing line with it.
One on my right, one also on my left. Pick up one. Cross with it. I'm going to pick up one crystal bead on my left fishing line. This is where I was coming from when it was like this. This is how I was going. This spot, I use my left fishing line to go around like this up to this point. I started only one bead with my right fishing line, then I crossed here. So I just turned it this way so I can do this row. So my left fishing line, I inserted one crystal bead and I passed through this bead. This is the only bead I'm passing into. Okay. One again on my left. Pick up one on my right. Let me stop it on my right. So now that I have this here, I have two on my left now. I'm going to make it three on my left, three on my right. I mean this crystal bead. I'm going to make three here, three on my right and cross it one sand bead. So now I'll pick up four sand bead. Going to this bead. Cool. One crystal bead on my right again. Four sand bead. Still on my right fishing line. and the last crystal bead on my right. Pick up on my left fitting line, picking up 4 sand beads. Into this one before or after the crystal bead. Now I have this crystal bead. So I'm going to cross both fishing lines with 1 sand bead. One on my left, one on my right. Cross both fishing lines with 1 sand bead. You can see we have 3 already on this row. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So we have 3 here. So we're going to make 7 more. Make 7 more on this row. Then you turn back to this spot. Repeat the same way you've been doing this 7 more times. Then the last one you're going to turn to get to this spot. I'll be back to show you that. Alright, I have the 10th one now on this row. So I'm going to create this one here that will enable me to turn to get this. So pick up 1 crystal bead, four sand bead, pick up 1 crystal bead, then 4 sand bead. Another 4 sand bead. one sand bead. Sorry. I've got I'm quitting. This place. Almost forgot it. Pick up one crystal bead. Pick up four sandy. going to this one again. And twist a bit on my right. For sand bead. Excuse me. Then tie up. Start by picking up one crystal bead on my left. Pass into this. Pick up another crystal bead. Into this another one to my left, into this one. Another one. I'm going to pass both fishing line into one crystal bead. This is the way I normally do my own. Pick up two topper bead. Pass both fishing line into one is already on it. Can use the different hook if you want to. I'm just demonstrating how I finish up my own. Back into the stop bead. And into the crystal bead. Coming out from there, I'm going to pick up one sand bead on my left and one on my right. Pass both fishing lines into one crystal bead. pass both fishing lines into your fishing, pass both fishing line into your stock bead just like you did before. And attach the other half of your hook. Pass it back. Be careful so you don't skip one. Okay. Different persons with different method of attaching the hook can do what is best for you. That's just the way I do my own. You can see it's done. Very easy to make, not difficult. Alright, this is what I have. Alright, I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for watching. Please like and share, and don't forget to subscribe if you're a new member for more updates. Bye.